Good morning.
Good morning.
It's good to have you here again today as we celebrate and rejoice in being God's people, being in a building that we know and we love and we've forgotten. You know, it's amazing how many things that you look at and go, was that always here? But we're glad we're here. We're glad to be people of God, reminding ourselves, whoever you are and wherever you may be, you are loved by God. And you're welcomed here. We have changed it a bit. You know, we used to say where you are, wherever you may be on your journey of faith. But as we move into this time where we are recognizing that we are doing ministry in very different ways, where we're sending out the service, it is being streamed again. And today is the first day when our service is going to the people of Camas Valley United Methodist Church. They're part of us now. The family has grown. So there will be opportunities if you're interested in going out and helping. We'll be doing some on-site worship with them. So if you're interested in doing that, please let me know. We'll schedule you in. But it's a great time to be together and to be God's people gathered. Quick announcement, if you're on the church council, 7 p.m. tomorrow night here at the church, out in the fellowship hall, we will meet, and we've got some stuff to talk about as we continue our relaunching. So if you're part of that, please come, be a part of it. If you want to come and you're not on church council, please do. Now, it does not mean if you show up, we will give you a job. We may. But we won't make, you know, say, somebody's in here, so, you know, you're on the new committee. But if you're interested, please come as we talk about how we're going to be God's people gathered and coming forward. So it is a good time to be together, to celebrate and give thanks to God. So I invite you to join me now as we come together and worship and sing. Hello. Source of life and joy, source of hope and peace. Fill us this day, and let us be yours in all we do. Give us courage, give us wisdom, and Lord, give us a hungry heart that we might grow in faith, we might grow in discipleship, we might grow in our witness to all the world. We pray this in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God forever and ever. Amen. I invite you to be seated.
In Celtic theology, there are thin places where the distance between heaven and earth seems to disappear. Those who find those thin places experience the presence of God in amazing and transforming ways. They experience grace and renewal. Maybe you have come across a thin place in your life. Perhaps you have a place you go when life gets difficult. You experience a thin place where you and God commune. We experience those thin places in the sacraments. We find ourselves in holy places where our spirits are filled and our lives transformed. We will be discussing these holy moments and talking about the sacraments of the United Methodist Church in the next 3 weeks. This week, we will focus on becoming aware of the thin places of our lives. Hear now the Word of God from Acts 2, 37 through 42 from the Common English Bible. When the crowd heard this, they were deeply troubled. They said to Peter and the other apostles, "Brothers, what should we do?" Peter replied, "Change your hearts and lives. Each of you must be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins. Then you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. This promise is for you, your children, and for all who are far away, as many as the Lord our God invites." With many other words, he testified to them and encouraged them, saying, "Be saved from this perverse generation." Those who accepted Peter's message were baptized. God brought about 3,000 people into the community on that day. The believers devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching, to the community, to their shared meals, and to their prayers.
Oh,
I invite you to join me in prayer. Come, Holy Spirit, as we gather in this holy place, as we gather as your holy people, remind us that you are reaching down to touch us, that you are always seeking us out. Help us, Lord, to find places, to find time, to find your presence in our daily life. To that end, may my words and may all our meditations be pleasing to you, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. I remember one time I was working with the Soil Conservation Service in southern Idaho in an area, if you are at all aware, if you know anything about Idaho, southern Idaho is mostly high desert steppe. I won't get into the difference between high desert steppe and desert because I'd put you all to sleep real quick. But the official title is high desert steppe. So we were wandering around through the sagebrush, and my boss had said, I want you to walk around this way, and I want you to map the soils. And so I was really enjoying that, taking it in, digging the holes where I needed to, doing everything. And then I came up over a ridge and could see pretty much all of southern Idaho. And it was just one of those gorgeous moments. Celtic theology calls that a thin place, where the distance between heaven and earth seems to shrink, where you are in the presence of God and there are no real special words. It's just a feeling. Maybe you've all had that one way or another, when you experience the presence of the living God and you can go back there, and time after time it just seems as though God is there in a special way. You know, some at community of Iona is known as one of those thin places. There are several that are throughout the world that I don't know whether they always were thin or because people started looking for it. But I would encourage you to find those thin places. And if you tell me that you're visiting one of your thin places, I won't even mark you absent from church. You know, because that is an experience. Now, if you tell me your thin place is at the golf course, you're going to have to take me out and prove it. You know, if you can make it through a couple of double and triple bogeys and still have a smile on your face, then we can talk about it being a thin place. But it is that moment, that holy moment, when we come into the presence of God, when we experience the grace of God in very real and very powerful ways. Now, there are any number of ways to do that, and the church has tried over its history to find those means of grace, those thin places that we can celebrate within the life of the church. You know, because so often they happen regardless. You know, I've been in church when I've had just this amazing holy experience, and I go back the next week, and yeah, you know, you kind of look at God and say, we survived that one, didn't we? But there are those experiences that we say, this is a way to experience the grace and love of God in specific ways, and different denominations have different ways of experience of celebrating that. If you have a Roman Catholic background, you know, there are seven sacraments. Baptism, confession, confirmation, holy orders, ordination, prayer for the sick, communion, and one other. Check back with me later and I'll tell you. You can see I slept through that part of church history. But within the United Methodist Church, we recognize that there are two of them. There's baptism and communion. And we say those are the two that we celebrate because those are two that came to us from Jesus. And we're going to talk more specifically about those two in the next couple of weeks. Next week we'll do baptism and we will do a renewal of baptismal vows. And we'll talk about communion as that experience. But the focus now is that these are places, these are times when we say we experience the gospel in unique and powerful ways. That we recognize we enter into a divine mystery. You know, we can talk about what a means of grace is or a sacrament is, and we have book after book after book written on why there should be two, there should be three, there should be seven. There are no such thing as a sacrament. There are ordinances, all in all in all. And we just have this delightful intellectual, theological discussion over something that when you get right down to it is a mystery. Now, I truly do enjoy the discussing of theological ideas. That's one of the great things that I enjoy. But I recognize that faith is not based on correct theology, because our theologies differ so much. Our call is to live the love of God and to learn to get along with one another and to recognize that though our theologies are different and we disagree on issues, we are together on the fact that we experience the love of God in profound ways. The means of grace. It's a time when we gather together and we experience something. I said so many times, it just happens. One that I remember was on a walk to Emmaus. I think I've told you about this one, where there was a meal being served and they had a bunch of music boxes wound up. And they all were playing, and everybody said, oh, isn't that beautiful? And then it ended, Amazing Grace. There, I'd have to get this right. I look at Kim, I'm telling the story through her. She was the one who was actually there. All of the other music boxes died out, and you hear the end of Amazing Grace. And it became a holy moment, a gorgeous moment where everybody, you know, the goosebumps were there, and everybody knew we were in the presence of God. And it just stood there. There were no words. So I decided we're going to make sure that happens again. Next time, next year, next fall, whenever they had the same meal at the same gathering in the walk to Emmaus, they wound up the music boxes, and they took the Amazing Grace music box, and they let all of the others start first so that this would be the one. You know, they were going to make sure it happened, and they played, and then all of them wound down. And instead of hearing Amazing Grace, you hear bum, 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 bum. That was a glorious, fun moment, and maybe even a holy moment, but not the moment that they were expecting. Sometimes when we try to force holy moments, that just doesn't happen. You know, I practice a thing called centering prayer. I'm not real great at it, but centering prayer says that you sit for 30 minutes in the presence of God without any thoughts. I challenge you to do that for 30 seconds. Because, you know, if you're like me, you sit down and you go, okay, I'm in prayer. Did you turn off the water to the garden? No, I'm in prayer. Have you ever noticed how that clock ticks really loud? You know, brain thoughts coming in and all kinds of stuff. And there are times when I'm able to put those out and I'm really in an experience of the presence of God, and I am renewed, and I know that God's love is real and powerful, and there are times when I think both God and I have fallen asleep. We survived. But the holy moments are those times that come to us when we experience at a visceral level the presence of the living God. John Wesley, when he said, I realize that grace was for me, and for Wesley, this was an ecstatic utterance when he said, I felt my heart strangely warmed. You know, Methodists don't have a chance of being really emotional when our leader, his word for when he became renewed in faith was I found my heart strangely warmed. But it was an experience of the living God. It was an experience where his life was fundamentally changed. And faith became real to him. And the presence of God became real to him. A holy moment. Now, I encourage you to be aware of those holy moments that are around you. They come in so many different ways. They come when you're with family and you just enjoy being together. They come in moments when you read a book and something happens. You see things differently. When you watch television, you see there's almost nothing that's not an opportunity for the Spirit of God to come and to find those thin places where you experience the presence of God and to enjoy them. Not to try to figure them out. Not to try to analyze them, but in this case, simply to be in the presence of God. All things are well, Teresa of Avila said. All things are well. And all manner of things are well. A moment of holy presence with the living God. When you know that God's living and God is in your life. For the church, as we talk about it, we pick up those two sacraments as experiences of the presence of God. When we remember, when we come back together and we say, this is who we are. This is an experience of grace. When you're baptized, if you remember baptism, if you're confirmed, when you come to communion, moments of high grace, of high joy, of amazing solemnity, being in the presence of people who know you, I am amazed that when I finally was finally baptized when I was in high school, that people just didn't burst out in laughter. You know, we know you so well. We know all the things that you've done. You know, I was one of the people who broke into the church to play ping pong. That shows you the highlight of my criminal life. But you know, I just was one of those people, if there's something stupid to do, I did it twice. Because I wasn't sure the first one really counted. And they loved me. And they stood with me and they said, we will be with you. And to be in those moments when we experience grace, we experience love physically, when we experience people who come together in communion, when we sing those songs that we love, and everybody has a different one. We experience it. When we're with spouses, you know, there's so many ways, and it's so easy to become inured to that, to become, that was something. To become bored with it, to try to dictate it. I encourage you this week to look for the thin places where heaven and earth are close together, where God is reaching down to touch you, to just be aware of the presence of God wherever you are, and celebrate that, and live in that, and rejoice in that, as experience of the means of grace, of the living out of the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Remind ourselves, we are saved by grace through faith. We are saved because of God's love for us, God reaching down and grabbing us and loving on us until we understand what it means to be loved. We experience thin places. Thanks be to God. Please join me as we come to God in worship. Would ask if there are joys, concerns that we can share with one another. Shout them out, and if I hear them, I'll share them out for everybody.
Monica.
Pardon?
Monica.
Okay.
You ready?
Being here together, yeah.
My joy is I I'm doing better, and so is my daughter.
Super. Super. Glad you're both doing better.
My nephew Jack.
For Jack. Jack Herbeck with cancer.
He celebrated 61 years last week.
61 years. Congratulations. Would ask that we keep Roz press in prayers. There's some, she's having some physical issues, and she's asked that we pray for her. So keep Roz in your prayer. Others?
Gloria.
Pardon?
Gloria.
Gloria. Okay. And also people who are in the path of the fires. The book fire, whichever exploded, it's over 100,000 acres now. They've said it's some of the worst fire conditions they've seen. So for safety, for those who were fighting it, and for God to be with us in the midst of that, as with all the other fires throughout the world. Let's go to God in prayer. Holy and gracious One, You speak to us. And God, sometimes we're too busy to listen. Sometimes we're too frustrated to listen, and yet you never stop calling after us. Until when we turn to You in our frustration, our sorrow, our anger, our doubt, our fear, all of our humanity, You greet us in love, asking only to be allowed to love us. So God, we open ourselves. Here we are. Let Your love flow in us and flow through us. Let us be transformed by You into Your amazing people of love and grace. That our prayers for our sisters and brothers, our prayers for our world would be filled with that love. That we would trust in You when things don't look too good, that we would know that You are walking with us. So we give You thanks, God. We give You thanks for Your healing, loving, grace-filled presence. We give You thanks for Your compassionate presence. We give You thanks that there's no place that we can go, but that You are already there. God, hear us as we celebrate worshiping in our sanctuary, as we celebrate a new launch of being Roseburg United Methodist Church. And it is as Your people, celebrating those who have gone before and those who will come after, that we pray the prayer that Jesus teaches. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Thank you. launched the church, we do things differently. You know, from the time I grew up, the plates were passed back and forth. And right now, we don't do that. But we still have opportunities to be in ministry. We have the plates at the back of the church. If you have your offering, we encourage you to bring that back, to take that back there. You can always write a check, mail it to the church, 1771 West Harvard Avenue, Roseburg, Oregon, 97471. You can go to the Give Plus app and join, be on that, follow the giving there, or you can go to the website and give, fumcroseburg.org, click on the Give Now button. Now, I know you all who are sitting here know all of those things, and you're saying, how many times am I going to continue to say that? Well, we're going all over the place now with the streaming, so we're giving people an opportunity to be in ministry, to join with us wherever they are. So, again, if you are watching this and you have a home church, that's where your giving goes. But together, we are making a difference for Jesus Christ. We celebrate that. Join me in prayer for the work that we are doing. Gracious God, for all the gifts that you have given to us, we are profoundly grateful. And for this opportunity to join with you, join with our sisters and brothers in making a difference, in taking whatever we have, Lord, may it be multiplied and compounded, a mustard seed gift that transforms the world. We give you thanks and praise. Amen. I invite you to stand as we sing.
Thank you.
is seeking us. God is offering us thin places where we can rest and renew in the power of God in order to be God's people, creating thin places for others. Go in the grace and peace and love of God our Creator, Christ the Holy Spirit, Christ and the Holy Spirit. Go make a difference. Thanks be to God. Amen.